My name is Robert Fitzgerald, and I am the music teacher here at Monterey Elementary, and I'm glad that you've decided to come and join us this evening for Trina and the second grade performance. We're super excited. They did this today. They were super excited. The students are super excited. I hope you enjoy Trina and the second graders. Give them a round of applause. So, without any further ado, let's get Trina started. Good evening, Trina.
It's my treat to be here. I love to come every year to sing with you and spread Christmas spirit and cheer. Can I sing my favorite Christmas song for everyone?
Sure, we'd love to hear your song, Trina. Let's sing Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree.
Yo, what you want for Christmas, dude? Rocking around the Christmas tree, ain't nobody seen a tree like me. All decked out with lots of bling, your eyes light up when you hear me sing. I wish upon that Christmas star that you sing this chorus in your car. Merry Christmas. Word to your mother. Peace. I just love being in your school, and I love singing. Do you know what my favorite subject is in school?
What is it?
History. I love studying all about the United States of America and our country. I also like math, like geometry and trigonometry. And I know what's 100 plus 100 plus 100.
What is 100 plus 100 plus 100?
300, of course. Hey, do you have computers at your school?
Yeah, Trina, we have computers at our school.
You know, computers were invented by a tree.
I don't think so, Trina. How could a tree invent a computer?
Well, I don't know how, but why else would the teachers always tell students to log in?
Why don't you let me think about it while we sing Jingle Bells?
and Mrs. Radcliffe and Mrs. Wishon and Mrs. Watley. They've been really naughty.
Trina, I told you to be nice. We practice good character here at Monitor Elementary.
Good character? Do you know what the elves practice at elf school?
What's that?
The alphabet. I know a lot of great Christmas jokes. Telling jokes is my special treat. What's invisible and smells like milk and cookies?
What, Trina?
Santa's burps. Do you know what you get when you cross a Christmas tree with an apple?
What is it, Trina?
A pineapple. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Dexter.
Dexter who?
Dexter Halls with boughs of holly. Tis the season to be jolly.
It sure is, Trina. Rest your throat while we sing some more songs.
Do you know the one about Santa's famous reindeer? I think his name is Robin or Rebecca or Roland.
His name is Rudolph, and we sure do know a song.
You know Dasher and Dancer, Prancer and Vixen.
Olive who?
Olive the other reindeer. I think it's great that Rudolph and Santa are coming. But did you know the real reason we celebrate Christmas is because of Jesus' birthday?
Our choir sings a great song about Jesus' birthday. I think we should sing it for you right now. Your cousin Oak Tree is a corny guy.
We have another cousin, Artie Fishel. He's not as funny as we are, but he's trying to think out of the box. What about your choir, Mr. Fitz? Think they are ready to branch out and sing another song about the night Jesus was born?
I think we're ready, Trina.
manger the night he was born. Now, I know that Mary and Joseph were there, and the wise men, and the angels, and the animals, but I'm not sure about one thing. Was Frosty the snowman there too?
No, Trina, I don't think there were any snowmen in the manger.
Well, I still think about snowmen at Christmas time, and I dream of snow and having a white Christmas every year. I like snowmen. Do you know what snowmen do over Christmas break?
What do snowmen do over Christmas break, Trina?
They just chill out. Mr. Fitz, I'm wondering if your choir knows two songs about Jesus' birth. Do they know three songs about Jesus being born?
If you mean three songs, yes we do. We also know the song, Go Tell It on the Mountain. It's one of our favorites.
Thank you.
sleep, would you like to hear a bedtime story? And some more poetry?
We would love that, wouldn't we?
Yes!
'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a pig.
Trina, it's a mouse. It's a mouse, not a pig.
The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas would lose all his hair.
Santa is not losing his hair. It's in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there.
The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of Marco's pizza danced in their heads, because I ordered Marco's pizza, and when this is over, I'm going to pick it up in the hall right outside the cafeteria door.
Sounds good.
When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from the bed and stuck my toe on the ladder. Ouch!
Trina, there's no ladder. You sprang from the bed to see what was the matter.
Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters, and threw up the sash.
Trina, you didn't throw up. You threw up the sash. It means you opened the curtains.
The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature tractor? It was a John Deere.
But a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny, tiny reindeer. It's reindeer, not a John Deere tractor. That's 2 different things.
With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now happy, now sleepy, now dopey and grumpy.
Trina, stop. Those are the 7 dwarfs, not Santa's 8 reindeer.
Oops, sorry.
It's all right.
To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot. Doesn't he have 2 feet? I don't know. And his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. His eyes, how they twinkled. His dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses. His nose was so hairy.
Like a cherry, Trina. His nose was like a cherry.
He stuck a cherry up his nose? Why would he stick a cherry up his nose? Ooh!
No, Trina, he didn't stick a cherry up his nose.
His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. He had a broad face and a round little belly that shook when he laughed like peanut butter and jelly.
A bowl full of jelly.
He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk. And laying his finger inside of his nose.
Not inside of his nose, a side of his nose.
It was inside of his nose. He was trying to get that cherry out. And giving a nod up the chimney, he rose. He sprung to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle. And away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." Mr. Fitz, I've had so much fun spending the day with you today. I hope all of you have a very hairy Christmas and a happy new year.
Not hairy Christmas, it's Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas.
to all a good night.
Good night, Trina. Good night, Trina. Good night, Trina. Merry Christmas. Thank you all for coming to our second grade performance of Trina, the Singing Christmas Tree. Give these second graders a round of applause. I need to thank several other people before I dismiss the kids. I need to thank Ms. Hampton, Ms. Huntsman, Ms. Sean, Ms. Radcliffe, and Ms. Watley, and Ms. Campbell. I think that's all of them. I also need to thank all of the SFLP parents that came and helped me with the trees. I also need to thank my family who helped me come with the trees, and also the First United Methodist Church confirmation class. So give them a round of applause.